I'd love to welcome here for this interview Rick Vanderlands, independent analyst, author, and consultant. So Rick, tell me what you do to help all these people figure out, you know, how to deal with their data management problems.
Well, I help out by writing a lot of articles and blogs, doing sessions such as this, training seminars, let's say, and then I help out with in consultancy forums to help out coming up with new data architecture. So I think that's how I help people to improve their data management, to work with data virtualization. What can you do with it? What is not really feasible with the technology? The use cases of data virtualization. I think I'm using all the mechanisms we have to sort of help out with that.
Exactly. And one of the things I think we really appreciate is, you know, Rick is very, you're true to the customer's need, not so much the vendor. So you have often pointed out things we ought to do with our roadmap and challenges that customers have that we need to solve. So as an independent consultant, it's very important advice that you can give to the end customers.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Well, this presentation you had today, you know, I think a lot of the people saw it, but the thing I liked about it was not overly complex in the beginning, and you took people through step by step. Is this your experience also, that when you are approaching a new client, they don't get what is data virtualization, and you have to slowly give them examples of use cases? And what do you find clicks the aha moment in the customer when they are learning about data virtualization?
Right. Well, I think if you introduce data virtualization technology with a customer, I think you have to spend time on how to sort of convince them that this is sort of the right technology. Not always easy, because there's always resistance. You probably know that from your angle as a vendor. But there's always resistance. Is the performance okay? Is the functionality okay? Can't we do it with the technology that we have? So you should always spend some time in sort of explaining to them what it is. It's almost like selling the whole concept. You have to do that. I always sort of, in my planning, in my project, I reserve time for that. Yes, but you have to. And then the moment you start, I think it's always best to think from a use case standpoint, because a use case can deliver a return on investment. Right. And I'm not a big fan of sort of starting these two-year projects, where
architectural, big vision, etc. You just want to prove something quickly.
Yeah. Right, you have to have a big vision. I think that's always a good thing, but you have to build quickly, right? In very small steps, so that the business can also see that, hey, they developed something that I can use with that new data virtualization technology.
Can you give me a short example of a very quick success showing business value? You don't have to mention the exact customer name, but someone who got a pop out of this very quickly?
I think from all kinds of industries, to be honest, lots of use cases where really companies, they got it. So, for example, in the healthcare industry, a hospital, they clearly saw the advantage of allowing almost everyone within the hospital to get access to data. Those people knew that the data was there, they just didn't have access to it.
Right.
And now with data virtualization, they do. And I can name lots of customers who've had and who have seen those advantages. I think it's all about unlocking data, right?
Unlocking the data, access.
In an agile way.
Absolutely. So if customers are watching online, want to learn more about what your consultancy does, or learn about your book, etc., where would you point them?
To our website.
Yes.
Yeah, that's the easiest on the website, called www.r20.nl.
It's r20.nl.
I have lists of articles that I wrote on data virtualization. All the white papers I wrote for you guys are there. All the seminars that I'm doing worldwide are there. So almost every all the material is there, plus the books, including the one I just finished, which was published a few weeks ago, Data Virtualization Selected Writing. thing. So if right. just go to
this
the website.
This is your second book on the topic.
yes, yes. Yeah. And yes, I believe right. that's then the third book on data virtualization,
okay.
right?
Yes.
I think, yeah. Yeah.
Very good, very good. Well, please check it out. It's not in the virtual booth, but r20.nl. And I want to thank you again for being here at DataFest and opening with your keynote. I think it was very informative, and okay. We'll see you again.
Well, you're
thank
more than
you,
welcome.
Yes.
It was a pleasure.
It was a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.